Football stays unbeaten with a dominant performance at home. Women's tennis wins 3 times, and the volleyball team finds itself ranked among New England's best.
All that and more coming up next on a new edition of Panther Rewind. Hello, everyone. I'm Dan Salzer, alongside my partner and Chris Kilmer, as we welcome you to this week's edition of Panther Rewind, brought to you by Biederman's Deli.
The football team flexed its muscles in Saturday's home opening win over Maine Maritime Academy, 48-6. The Panthers accrued 428 yards of total offense and scored the most points in a decade, while the defense limited the Mariners to just 47 yards on the ground as the team moved to 2-0 on the year. Seniors David Hamilton and Nick Lancia led the offensive onslaught, combining for 165 yards on the ground and 4 touchdowns. Sophomore quarterback Brett Levanshi finished 8 of 13 for 114 yards and a score, while rookie Christian Paye completed his first collegiate pass for a 26-yard touchdown. On the defensive side, sophomore Caden Balageron and freshman Joey Casella both snagged their first career interceptions, while junior Elijah Buzzle recovered a fumble in the lopsided win. After the game, Dan caught up with head coach Paul Castonia.
I think we did some things consistently better today. On offense, we in the first half, we scored on every possession except when we shot ourselves in the foot. And defensively, again, I think we did a pretty good job preventing the big play. But again, we got to get guys in the right spots faster, and we got to tackle better.
The Panthers open MASCAC play on Saturday with a 1 o'clock kickoff against Worcester State.
Women's soccer had an up-and-down week, going 1-1, and now sit 2-3 overall. PSU picked up a win on the road at Colby Sawyer on Wednesday 2-0, thanks to sophomore Jordan Myers' third goal this season, while junior Mallory Lloyd tallied her first goal of the year. And in goal, Jenna Parsons, the junior, collected her second career shutout. Saturday was a different story for the Panthers as PSU dropped a tough match to Roger Williams at home 3-1. In rainy conditions, Roger Williams opened up an early 2-0 lead in the first 15 minutes. Junior Maya Golawash was a lone PSU scorer in the game, netting her first goal in a Panther uniform. As PSU gears up for another non-conference game tonight at Curry College, head coach Ryan Joy is content with the loss, believing it will help the team heading towards the Little East Conference schedule.
I mean, just improve, right? So we have essentially 2 more games left until conference play starts, UMass Dartmouth right here on the 28th. So, you know, we've got 2 more pretests, if you will, to be ready for the big thing. So, you know, can we improve on some of the things that we, you know, needed to improve on just in looking at the last game? And if so, then we're continuing to take steps in the right direction. And, you know, no matter the result, as long as we're improving, then we're putting ourselves in the right spot come conference time.
The tennis team had a busy week, picking up 3 impressive wins while running its overall record to 4-1 on the season. The Panthers doubled up Colby Sawyer 6-3 on Wednesday, then gave up just 1 point in commanding wins over Salem State and Northern Vermont Johnson. The Panthers were deadlocked at 2 against Colby Sawyer before juniors Kirsten Venankasa and Jenna Sundquist and freshman Hannah Street ripped off straight set wins to secure the victory. PSU was overpowering while topping Salem State 8-1 to improve to 2-0 in the LEC Saturday. The Panthers swept doubles play and had an 8-0 lead before Salem State salvaged a point in the final completed match of the day. Plymouth State rolled over NVU Johnson 9-0 yesterday. PSU didn't drop a single game in doubles play, while freshman Alyssa Betancourt picked up her first career win. Every healthy player made an appearance to contribute to the victory. Head coach Barbara Rolski-Willett has been pleased with the team's progress so far.
We played very well against Colby Sawyer, and we played great against Salem State. Our doubles is starting to come together, our singles, we're hitting the ball well, we're executing plans during singles matches, and today we had contributions from every single player on the team. We need to stay consistent. We need to keep the ball in the court. Every Little East Conference, the conference is tough this year. Every Little East Conference match is going to be a tough one, and we need to play well every single time.
PSU is home for 2 more matches this week, hosting NVU Linden tomorrow and UMass Boston in LEC play on Saturday.
Field hockey dropped their only game in the week in the conference opener at WestCon 2-0 on Saturday. With a loss, the Panthers dropped to 2-2 on the season. Sophomore Megan Allard made 3 saves in net in her debut and goal for the Panthers, conceding 2 goals on the 11 first half shots by the Colonials. Junior Haley Wakefield led the Panthers' offense with 5 shots on goal, while sophomore Jess Mesquita tallied 3 shots of her own, but PSU was unable to find the back of the net. As the Panthers get one more non-conference tune-up tonight at New England College before PSU hits the heart of their conference schedule, head coach Bonnie Lord knows there were good things to take away from the loss.
You know, the defense is stepping up, the midfield, the forwards. We knew that WestCon was going to be a formidable opponent, and they were. And we need to step up our game. You know, it's kind of warm up when you're going through your non-conference games. You want to be successful, but it's not your number one focus. It's more about growth and improvement. And once we hit conference play, then it's the real world. And you're going after the end of your season then, even though we only look at it one game ahead.
It looked like the volleyball team was on its way to a 10-0 start after taking a 2-0 lead against Eastern Nazarene on Wednesday. But the host Lions had other plans, storming back to win in 5 sets. The setback snapped the 4th longest unbeaten streak to open a season in the 24-year history of the program, but the Panthers came back with a vengeance. PSU shook off the loss with a pair of solid performances in 3-0 wins over Mount Holyoke and Norwich at home on Saturday. Sophomore Alexa Price averaged nearly 11 assists per set and totaled 16 digs on Saturday, while senior Lex Bowers led the team with 17 kills and added 21 digs. Junior Carabeth Norklin also had a big day, finishing with 15 kills and 6 blocks. The Panthers' hot start earned them a spot in the first NUVA poll last week, where PSU was ranked 13th in New England. Despite the great start, head coach Joan Forge isn't content. PSU has 3 matches this week, heading to Regis on Thursday before traveling to Salve Regina on Saturday, where the Panthers will face the Hawks as well as St. Joseph's of Long Island.
Well, you know, we were ranked 13th in New England, which is really wonderful. We've got 11 wins in the beginning of the season, which is unbelievable. But there's still so much to work on. And all the players know that. They're not content where they are. We're still striving for perfection. We want to cut back on our errors. We want to be stronger in every aspect of our game, serve, receive, defense, offense. There's just so much to work on. And they're still driven. And that's what we love about it. They're passionate about the game. They want to improve. They're not content.
Men's soccer suffered a setback in their lone game of the week last Wednesday with a 4-3 overtime loss at Pine Manor. The loss drops the Panthers to 1-2 overall this season. PSU rallied from a 2-goal deficit at the half by scoring 3 second-half goals thanks to juniors Cam Bunn and Cam Macedo and sophomore Ryan Brown. The Panthers conceded the lead when junior Linus Lindenberg made a save that deflected off a defender into the net, sending the game to overtime, where the Gators scored the game winner 5 minutes into the extra frame. PSU looks to bounce back this afternoon at home against Johnson and Wales before enjoying a week off from competition. That will do it for this week's edition of Panther Rewind. For my partner Chris Kilmer, I'm Dan Salzer. We'll see you at the games this week.